there are.
Jingle bells swing, yeah, jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chime and jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air, what a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night away. Jingle bell time is a swell time to go gliding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. A jingle around the clock. Mix and a mingle in the jingling beat. That's the jingle bell. Rock. Jingle bell chiming, jingle bell time. Snowing and blowing are bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells chiming, jingle bell time. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square. In the frosty air, what a bright time. It's the right time to rock the night. Go gliding in a one-horse sleigh. Giddy up, jingle horse, pick up your feet. Jingle around the clock. A mix and a mingle and a jingling beat. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell. That's the jingle bell.
The juniors and seniors of Warrior Vision visited Prospect for their annual Santa's workshop. They set up three workshops for the pre-K kids. The first workshop involved story time. Students sat and read holiday favorites to our youngest little warriors. After stories were finished, Warrior Vision students asked our pre-K boys and girls questions about the books and the holidays in general. Together, they made a healthy holiday snack. In the second workshop, the kids made two holiday ornaments out of popsicle sticks, a Santa hat, and a snowman. Working together, they made special ornaments to add to their tree for this holiday season. For the final workshop, and the favorite of the day, Warrior Vision brought in a special guest, Santa Claus himself. While waiting to talk to Santa, boys and girls colored holiday-themed coloring sheets. When their turn came, they went to talk to Santa personally, pleading their case of being nice and not naughty, and finally telling Santa what they hoped to find under the tree Christmas morning. Here are some of the responses.
Ho, ho, ho.
Yeah. What do you want for Christmas?
I forget.
Forget?
You forget? Well, what about like dolls? Do you want dolls? Okay. What other things do you like?
I like tablets. My tablet didn't charge.
Your tablet didn't charge?
No. No, because it won't work.
You want a new one?
Beetlejuice. Please. A pencil.
Yeah. You want to be next after her?
A daddy okay. From work.
Yeah?
It's daddy. It's daddy.
Are you a phone?
A sled.
A sled?
A dollhouse.
A nerf gun.
I want Our new kitchen and some pans and some food and some milk and some Transformers toys.
What do you want for Christmas?
No.
You want to tell me and I'll tell him? No.
A toy jack.
Yeah?
And a football is a toy thing I wanted for Christmas. It's that I screwed it.
Perfect. Is that all you want to tell him?
Yeah.
Okay.
The toys.
What kind of toys?
Toy Story.
Toy Story? Yeah. Who's your favorite person from Toy Story?
Buzz and Woody.
Whoa.
A dinosaur.
What else do you want?
A ceratops.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Is that all? Okay, you want to go color?
On behalf of everyone here at Warrior Vision, have a very Merry Christmas.
Santa, tell me if you're really there. Don't make me fall in love again if he won't be here next year. Santa, tell me if he really cares. 'Cause I can't give it all away if he won't be here next year. Feeling Christmas all around and I'm trying to play it cool, but it's hard to focus when I see him walking across the room. Let it snow.
Hello, welcome back to Christmas Jeopardy. We're currently in our round two. Here we have Walter
Hobbs with negative 500 billion. No neck Sandy McFaddy with
negative 5 trillion. And Ron with Butcher.
Yeah.
With negative 2 million.
Okay, let's get back to the board contestants. Walter, it's your pick, your choice.
Christmas movies for 100. Eggnog drinking contest! Open up your eggnog. 3, 2, 1, go!
I don't like eggnog.
Walter Hobbs wins.
Okay.
What?
Of course.
Of course!
Okay, Walter, what would you like next?
Christmas movies for 200.
In A Christmas Story, what
body part was the lamp? Sandy.
I'm gonna go with a knee.
Any other contestant? Walter?
A woman's head.
A foot.
Incorrect.
Oh, man.
Walter, it's your choice again.
Wait, what was the answer, sir?
It was a leg.
I was close.
I said a knee.
I was close.
That's two different body parts, but thank you for the challenge.
Okay, thank you.
So, your choice?
I'm gonna go with Christmas movies for 400.
Christmas movies for 400.
What was the reason for the Grinch hating Christmas?
Sandy?
His heart was two sizes too big.
Incorrect! Walter.
His heart was two sizes too... I don't know.
Ding, 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 ding.
Butcher.
He hated children.
Incorrect. His head. You were close there, Sandy, but...
His heart was two sizes too small.
Okay. What would you like next?
Who goes?
You, Sandy, no neck.
Christmas lyrics for 400.
Christmas lyrics for 400. Dreidel spin off!
Oh! Oh!
Okay, so for our final Jeopardy, you have to draw something. The wager does not count. Draw something. It could be a picture. It could be a pony. It could be the number one. Draw something. Ready? Begin.
Sorry for the interruption, but in the end, all three contestants were wrong. Sandy McFaddy prevailed, and it was her life mission to win Jeopardy, so we were glad to make that goal hit accomplished for her.
Yay! Good job, buddy!
I won!
Winter weather can be difficult and tricky to predict, especially at 4 and 5 a.m. In determining if schools should be closed or delayed, much care and consideration is given to understand the weather patterns, conditions of the roads, and most importantly, the safety of our students, drivers, and staff.
Hi, my name is Bob Finch. I'm the head bus driver of the Salamanca Bus Garage. How do I make my determination that I report to Mr. Breinstein on the weather is on my drive in, I pay attention to what's around me. I make a small loop around the town, you know, with further determination on what I fact email to Mr. Breinstein, which he carries out on his determination of closing the school.
That way we are in a position to decide if we are going to close, generally by 5:30 a.m. Once we decide to close, we are closed and all activities are canceled for that day, including sports, clubs, activities, and meetings. We notify the community in this order to maximize our coverage. Our Facebook page, our district website, an automated phone call, text messaging, and email service known as Blackboard Direct, and then television and radio stations. During the school day, we take the same care and consideration to determine if after-school activities will be canceled, and generally we make that decision by 1 p.m. Safety is our priority and our concern, and we encourage everyone in the Warrior Nation to be aware, to be safe, and be alert. Thank you.
After a really good 2016-2017 basketball season with an overall record of 33-8 between the 18-2 JV and the 15-6 varsity, two JV players had a goal over the 9-month stretch till the next season to make the varsity team. They knew it was going to take a lot of hard work and dedication to push themselves to make the team. After last season, the varsity team lost 9 seniors and have only 3 returning players, so there's a huge role to fill. After the first 2 weeks of practice, they have definitely proven they have what it takes to play on the varsity level. I asked Jarrett McKenna myself what it took to earn a spot on the varsity team as a sophomore.
To make a spot on the varsity team, it took a lot of hard work and practicing all summer, like going to summer league and open gyms, and just keep practicing and working hard.
Isaac Brown is the first freshman to play for Coach Adam Bennett as a varsity coach. He is the first freshman to play on the varsity team since Jared Fish in 2011. Isaac spent his summer playing street ball and summer league. I asked Isaac what motivated him to try out for varsity.
What motivated me to try out for varsity was how many seniors left last year? 9. And last year, as an 8th grader on JV, I did pretty good, started. So Coach Bennett was really watching me last year, and he believed I could improve a lot to play on varsity. And over the summer, I worked hard doing tournaments and just playing basketball a lot, working on my left, finishing on my left, shooting, just all that stuff. And this year at tryouts, he could tell that I improved a lot. So that's what motivated me to play. And now I'm a starting freshman on varsity.
I'm Braden Siebert, and I'm here with Coach Bennett, boys varsity basketball coach. I'm going to ask him a few questions about this upcoming season. What's different from this year and last year?
I think we have less experience this year. Last year we had 9 seniors. This year we only have 4. So we have to try to acclimate new kids to the varsity level. But we do have a lot of talent, and that gives me hope about the season ahead. But we just have to make sure that we're as consistent as we were last year in order to win as many games as we can.
What do you expect to improve on from this year from last year?
We want to run the floor more this year. I think we have the ability to score more points this year. We've got to continue to defend and rebound. But you know, we certainly want to push the tempo this year. We have a lot of guards. We're athletic, and we should be able to run the floor. I think it's going to be a more exciting offensive style this year, and certainly we look to score some more points.
What is your overall goal for this year?
Every year in our program, our goal is to win a league title and a sectional title. And again, we have the talent to do it. We just have to put it together. You know, we have to try to get better every day, not worry about what the results are, but worry about the process and what we're doing every day to improve.
Thank you.
Acting that's going on over here. Very good, guys.
Would you like to introduce yourself?
Yes, my name is Eric Chemnitzer, and I am the drama club and choral teacher.
How long have you been a vocal teacher?
I've been a vocal teacher for about 13 years.
What's your favorite part of chorus?
My favorite part about chorus is getting students to work as a team and challenging them with different pieces.
You also do drama club. How long have you been a part of drama for?
I've been doing drama productions for almost 15 years now. in some capacity, whether it's vocal direction or helping out with the stage. This is the first show I've directed. I have been vocal director for about 12 shows.
Oh, why do you do drama, and what part do you enjoy the most?
It's something that I did when I was in high school, and I really have fun working with the students and working towards that goal of a final performance.
What show are you doing right now?
We are doing RoboCop the Musical. It's going to be awesome. No, I'm just kidding. We're not doing RoboCop. Just making you edit more. We are doing Elf Jr., and the show's going to be the 8th and 9th of December. Tomorrow, December 7th, we're actually going to be doing a daytime show for Seneca and Prospect.
What is a junior production?
A junior production is almost the same as a full production, except it has condensed scenes, so the scenes aren't as long. They have shorter songs. Some songs are removed from the actual full productions, and sometimes it may vary based on cast size.
How do you feel the show will go, and do you expect a big outcome?
I definitely expect a big outcome. I think that we're going to have a lot of people show up to the show. Elf is a very popular Christmas movie, and in December this is going to be a home run, I think.
Would you like to explain any other details on the show?
Come get a ticket. It's $8 and it's going to be awesome.
What are your plans for upcoming shows and shows in the future?
We're planning on doing Oliver in the Spring, which is a Tony Award winning show. A really awesome show about a poor boy who lives in a workhouse. In the future, I plan on doing things more competitively, such as going to the Kenny Awards and competing against other schools to try and win prizes.
All right, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
At the conclusion of every sports season, there are athletes from every school who get selected. From Salamanca, there were multiple athletes from many sports who were selected by the coaches from the other teams in the league. From girls soccer, Allie Hill made honorable mention and Lauren Krauser was made second team. So I asked Allie what it means to her to be recognized by the league.
To me, it's a big deal because the coaches are recognizing that I have a talent in soccer, and it's just means a lot because it shows that my hard work has been paying off. I am only a sophomore now, so hopefully as I keep on playing soccer in high school, I can make it to first team by my senior year.
Boys football had many athletes get recognized by the league. The athletes were Leland and Ira John, who made first team for offense, and Tyler Hedlund and Jeremiah Shoup, who made first team for defense. Nick Johnson, Asa John, and Tristan Gillette, who made second team for defense. Austin Reyes and Zach Helms made honorable mention for defense, and Zariah Armstrong, who made honorable mention for quarterback. So I asked Zariah and Tyler what it means to them to be recognized by the league.
Feels good being recognized by the league because it helps me and motivates me to want to do better for next season.
It was big. Only being a junior and making big 30 and first team along with some of my other teammates, Tyler John. It's big as juniors to get recognized for something like that. It really puts us ahead of the game for next year.
It's nice to see when hard work for our athletes pays off. So congratulations to these athletes for their accomplishments.
Within the past few years, Salamanca Fall Sports haven't been as successful as they used to be, but this past season gave people a different look on Salamanca Fall Sports. A lot of teams were more successful and more passionate than years in past. Some teams made huge changes on the field, while other teams made huge changes off the field. The football team turned around from last year, going 5-4 and winning the Chuck Funk Bowl after losing their star player Xander Edstrom.
It was a good football season this year. We had a lot of ups and downs, a lot of key players on the team this year. Ira John was an outbreak running back for us, and Tyler Hedlund had over 100 tackles. That was huge on defense for a safety. And you know, as young athletes with another season left, they're going to do big things next season. And I had a pretty good year offensively and defensively, and we had a lot of honorable mentions in all league, both first and second team this year, and predicted to finish last in the league. And finishing with a 5-4 record is a big deal for all us kids that haven't won more than one or two games on our varsity career. And it's going to be real Salamanca football, like how it was in the 90s when it was expected that you won a sectional title every single year, and if you didn't do that, you were a disgrace to the team that came before you, in a sense. So it's nice to say I was a part of the team that kind of turned around the atmosphere of football here at Salamanca.
The boys' soccer team merged with Cattaraugus Little Valley for their fourth year in a row and had another fairly successful season. They went 7-7-2 on the season after losing three starting defenders last season. Let's hear what Cam Pratt, who plays midfield, and Hunter McCauley, who starts at defense, have to say about their season.
The merge didn't affect us a lot, but it kind of drew us closer together because we had a lot of preseason time to like get together and get to know each other more. We had a lot of team bonding where we'd go to each other's houses or go to a different place and hang out and just get to know each other better. And the merge helped with like different skill sets because everyone has their own like specific skill, and like everybody's skills put together made the team a lot better.
So on the season we were 7-7-2. We really weren't expecting to be as good as we were because of what we lost from the past year with Michael Collins, Kellen Martin, and Jacob Davison in our back lineup. There's our starting defenders. Michael and Kellen were two phenomenal defenders, two of the best in the area, and losing them was huge because that was last year. That's what our team was, as it was our defense. Defense would move the ball up, and the momentum would carry, and that's how we scored or won the games we had. And it was just the way the game was played last season was completely different to this season. And then we came in this season with three new defenders, two defenders that I'm pretty sure have never played defense in their life, and then one returning defender. And we thought the defense was going to be bad and it wasn't going to be as good and it wasn't going to hold up to the expectations, but it ended up being one of our strongest areas on the field, and at times the defense and our goalie Bobby Steffi really ended up carrying the team. The tennis team had a 9-3 record and was the most successful team for fall sports here at Salamanca.
Well, I think we had a really good season. We had one of the best seasons that we've had in years. Like, I've never seen a season as well as we did this year. We won, I think our record was 9-3 or 9-4. So we had a winning record, which was great. Last year we didn't, and the year before that we didn't. We did pretty good leading the team, even just like with the seniors there.
I think that we'll do fine leading them. I don't know, it's going to be way different because we've never played singles before. And normally, like for tennis, you separate yourselves from the other students. You're not always working together, but you still have to like show them how to kind of be chill when you're at a match, and instead of like letting all your emotions just come out onto the court, like you have to like suppress those feelings for the time being and just go out there and play the game of tennis.
The swim team has a lot of young swimmers that set a lot of personal records and went far in their season.
Swim season was good. We had a lot of wonderful girls who were very nice to everybody that they met. We lost all our meets, but that's okay because we got a lot of PRs and we had more kids make it to sectionals than I've seen in a while. For diving, you have two judges and they judge your dive based on like how your toes are pointed, how well you go in the water without making a humongous splash, and overall like the quality of the dive. And it's tough for divers because it's all about the judge's opinion. So the judge could be having a bad day and just be like, you're getting a 4 and you can't do anything about it.
The volleyball team didn't have a very successful season, but the program looks to be building and they have a lot of young athletes moving up.
For myself, just and other coaches, working with high school girls is a different experience, and transferring the skills from practice to a game is one of the things that we stress a lot, and having the girls understand that what we do in practice has to transfer over, and the reason we do the drills are so that we don't have to use our brains, we just react. So that's one of the harder skills that seems very simple, but in a game is really crucial to have. And I think what makes me the most proud is when I have a girl who goes through the program and they become successful and they continue to play volleyball, whether it's with their family or at the ACC or intramurals or, you know, college, anything. Just continue that and encourage other people to play sports.
Overall, Salamanca fall sports seem to be getting back to the way they used to be years ago.
everybody. I am Brandon, and welcome to another segment of Babbling with Brandon. Today, my guest is very well known around the school for many different things, such as student government president, Warrior Vision producer, and he's also an all-around class clown. I am talking about the one and only Niles Panis. Oh, good morning, good morning. Today I'll be interviewing Mr. Panis on his heavy involvement in the bowling team. Mr. Panis, what has inspired you to join the bowling team?
You know what? I heard that there's a lot of good food, so I decided I might as well eat.
Considering your heavy involvement in school activities, how do you find time for practices or matches?
You know, sometimes you just gotta crunch your schedule, and I do have to move things here and there periodically, but I make time.
Given that you do have time to go practice, what's your favorite food while bowling?
Well, I do like their pizza, but I do want to try their spicy pickle fries.
Just a curious question here. What is your highest score so far?
I'd rather not answer that question.
I'm assuming bad, but building from that last question, how do you think you could improve that?
I think I should have open ears when I listen to teammates and coaches mentor me.
Okay, moving to the rookie questions. Being your first year, what opposing team do you think will be hardest to take down?
Well, I've heard a lot of talk about Allegheny Limestone, so I'd say they probably are the leading competitor.
Okay, on the bowling team, there are approximately around 15 people. How do you think you fall in those rankings?
Probably number 16.
I agree. So, has anyone given you any tips this year on how to help your bowling technique?
Yeah, there's a lot of people that have. One of them, Wild Bill Frazier.
Moving to a question about Coach Jankowski, has he given you any tips on your technical aspects of the game?
Well, he tried telling me the ball and chain method, how the ball should be hooked, linked to your foot, and that did help.
Sticking on the Jankowski subject, has he busted out any of the signature jokes?
Yeah, he has. It was about golf. Why do golfers bring two pairs of socks?
I don't know why.
Because one, in case he gets a hole in one.
That is a classic. Okay, do you get along with the majority of the teammates?
Yeah, I'd say so.
What has been your favorite memory thus far on the bowling team?
Probably when Brandon squatted me.
Do you think that you'll end up sticking with this sport going into your senior year?
Yeah, I would plan on doing so.
Mr. Panis, do you have anything that you would like to share, such as a new movie coming out, or maybe a book that you're trying to publish?
Yeah, I actually have a new documentary coming out. It's called Panis's Bowling Chronicles. I think you should watch it.
I would like to thank all of you for tuning in to Babbling with Brandon. Mr. Panis, I'd like to thank you for coming on to my show. What a lovely guest you have been. I wish you the best on your spiritual bowling journey. And once again, thank you for tuning in to Babbling with Brandon. Until next time, this has been a Brandon. A boomity bop.
Hi, I'm Warrior Vision reporter Haley Pond, here with Mr. Bean, the high school band conductor. Mr. Bean has been teaching the high school band and a general music class here at Salamanca these past 3 years. He has worked with many bands and orchestras, including the Buffalo Philharmonic. He also helps with the drama club productions in the pit. His love for music and school spirit helped bring back our pep band. Today we're going to be talking about Mr. Bean's selection into conducting the junior high area all-state band that took place on November 3rd and 4th of this year. When you first found out that you were selected to conduct, what was your reaction?
I was very excited, obviously, because who doesn't like these opportunities to showcase their talents and share their wealth of knowledge?
Is this something that you have been working for and hoping that you would get?
I've done a few of these in the past. You never really know when you're going to get selected. They just kind of call you or email you, say you've been selected. So something you really audition for or anticipate, you just wait and see what happens.
How did you prepare yourself for this big opportunity, and were you nervous?
No, I wasn't nervous. I've been doing this for such a long time. It just becomes part of my nature. But to prepare for it, I would do a lot of score studies. So I would look at and do some research on the pieces and and do a lot of listening as well.
Can you tell us a little bit about the first day of rehearsal?
The first day of rehearsal is usually very unique because we have all different talents of coming into one orchestra. So we have about 30-some different districts that were involved in this orchestra. So therefore, you have to get all these same, but not same personalities and the same mind frame that I'm in. So it's challenging the first day. It's kind of rough, I'll be honest. But slowly we come together and we have a great concert at the end.
Was the concert a success and did everything run smoothly?
Yeah, I think the concert went very well. They're very long days. So we rehearse about almost half a day on Friday and then all day on Saturday. So we start rehearsing on Saturday at 9 and the concert's not until around 5:30. So it's a long day. There's only about like an hour lunch break in the middle. So it takes a long time for that day to go through. And some of these kids are so young, they're not used to pacing themselves. So sometimes when the concert comes, they're a little overworked, to put it that way. So, and they don't know how, so the concert goes, it went very well, but I know some kids would probably like another shot at some of the passages that we did.
What was the level of talent from the area all-state students compared to the level of talent from the students in our band?
Well, as the more you go up the chain of all counties and junior, and then we have area all-state, then all-state, the talent does get greater just because you have so many more kids from more districts applying. You have the best of the best. And so even though we have a lot of talent here, you know, every school has a lot of talent as well. So they send their best, and so we end up with a pretty well-sounding ensemble.
Did you learn anything while you were there that you hope to bring back to the students here?
I learned that the same problems happen here and then in this ensemble or even the Philharmonic in Buffalo with professionals. It's the level of how much you need to ask them to do something. So you always have balance issues. You always have articulation issues and intonation issues. It just depends how extreme those issues are. So it was nice to kind of talk and learn about ways to rephrase things to help kids understand what I wanted to get across to them.
Were there any Salamanca students that were selected to play in the band?
Julian Ray was actually selected on baritone saxophone, so that was a great honor for her.
Do you encourage more of our students to audition for area all-state or even just all-county?
Absolutely. I think just the notion of getting outside the school, auditioning for someone else that's other than your normal teacher, is a great opportunity, and who knows, they'll take you. You might do very well and make it to the next level and continue on from there, and you'll be surprised. The kids will be surprised how well they can do and what the other ensembles will sound like, and they have that great experience.
Do you think this opportunity helped you better as a conductor, and if so, how?
Absolutely. Every time you have a chance to conduct, especially something that's out of your norm, you always learn so much. And then whether it be, like I said, through your score study or your balancing skills or whatever it may be as a conductor, you always learn little tricks and things that enhance your own conducting back at your own school.
Do you hope to get selected for any of the all-state or all-county bands again in the future?
I always hope to. You never know, like I said before, you never know when you're going to be selected, but it just kind of word passes around that who you are or what's going on in different areas, and people say, oh, let's give this guy a shot or lady a shot for these conducting jobs. So we'll see.
Overall, what did you enjoy about this experience?
I think the greatest thing about this experience is most of these kids do not have exposure to the music I selected for them. So I selected a lot of common, legit classical music, even though classical music is still alive and kids are coming from their own orchestras and bands from their own districts. A lot of them are not playing the rep that I selected because some of the rep I selected was much more difficult than they would do in any other school because they have all the kids to play it. So I think exposing these kids to all this rep was the greatest joy.
Okay. Thank you so much, Mr. Bean, for taking your time to answer these questions. And congratulations on being selected to conduct this wonderful event. Our music department really has grown and excelled ever since you started teaching here, and we're very lucky to have you. Until next time, this has been Warrior Vision reporter Haley Pond signing off.
Hello, I'm Carson Hogan. This is All-Star Hunter McCauley. Hunter is a junior here at Salamanca and gets very involved with this school. From soccer to baseball to basketball and a media member, there isn't anything Hunter can't do. Today we will be talking about Hunter's involvement in Salamanca sports. I've heard you played a different position this year in soccer, and I'd like to know how you like the change.
Well, I play defense now, and I went from midfield to defense. And I like defense because in my younger years of playing, I was always a defender. So I'm used to that role, and then once it came to the higher level, like modified and varsity, I switched to a midfield. And, you know, I started to get a little used to it, but being back at defense is where I like to be.
Would you consider staying at this position for soccer?
I hope I stay at it because I really like it and I know the team needs me there, so I'll do whatever's best for the team.
I understand that the soccer team has been merged for 3 years and you've played on two of those 3 years. How do you like the merge?
I enjoy the opportunity to meet a lot of new guys and just play with guys that you're not quite familiar with, but through the season you get to know them as a person, and team bonding really helps with that, and it shows on the field that we really get along.
Having the first couple weeks of basketball down, how do you think the basketball team will do this year?
I think we're looking good. After last year losing the 9 seniors that we had, we knew that a lot of people would have to step up to fill the role of those guys, but I think we're doing that just fine, and I think we'll have a successful season.
What position do you play for the varsity basketball team?
I'm a guard and a forward.
How do you think the baseball team will do with a new head coach once again?
It's hard to say because I don't know the coach, but from years in past, we've kind of struggled. But with the first few years under a new head coach, it's not just going to come easy, and we're not just going to have a breakout season. So we're just going to have to work for it, see what the coach has for us, and work hard every day.
How do you think the team will adapt to yet again another head coach?
I don't really know. I'm hoping we adapt well to the coach, but it's hard to tell. I've only talked to the coach a few times, and it wasn't related to baseball in any way, so it's very hard to tell, but I hope we adapt very well.
Do you think the baseball team will actually win some games this year?
I'm hoping we can. We have a lot of young talent and a lot of guys that definitely can get the job done. After losing our star player last year with Xander Edstrom, there's some roles to fill, but I think we'll be good and get the job done.
Do you think the baseball team will upgrade their equipment soon?
I don't really know. I'm hoping, because we definitely do need some new equipment. But I heard that we are switching fields this year and playing over at Vets Park. That is just rumor, though, so I'm not sure. But I'm hoping it's true, and I'm hoping we get some new equipment because it's definitely needed.
Thank you, Hunter, for coming out and talking to us today. It's been great. We hope you have a good year in all your sports and years to come. This has been Carson Hogue giving you the future of Salamanca Sports.